Hey guys, this is Ben, back with my review of Martin Scorsese's newest film, Killers of the Flower Moon. In the 1920s, members of the Osage Native American tribe of Osage County, Oklahoma, are murdered after oil is found on their land, and the FBI decides to investigate. This is a 3.5 hour long crime epic starring one of the best actors working today, Leonardo DiCaprio, alongside Robert De Niro, Lily Gladstone, Jesse Plemons, and many others. Now, of course, this is a very hotly anticipated film when you got Martin Scorsese directing and Leo starring, so I was very much looking forward to this film. Now, this is a movie that is both very different from anything Martin Scorsese has done before in its time period and its subject matter, but also a film that feels right up his alley. Like I said, this is another crime film as we follow the many murders that occurred in this town and how our lead characters are involved. The film explores what is honestly a pretty tragic time in American history, and Martin Scorsese does not hold back in showing just how tragic and dire these events were. It's a meditation on greed and privilege as we see these white colonizers exploit the Native Americans, taking their wealth and erasing their culture. And all Martin Scorsese has to do to communicate this message is simply just depict the events as they happened, and he really does go in depth, unraveling every layer, showing you every side to the story and how these events unfolded. And I thought that he did a phenomenal job in doing so. Killers of the Flower Moon really shows Martin Scorsese at the height of his directorial prowess. At 80 years old, he has mastered how to tell a compelling and impactful story through his direction. $200 million budget dramas like this just don't get made all that often anymore, unless your name is Martin Scorsese, Christopher Nolan, or Steven Spielberg. You just don't get these massive budget dramas anymore. And it's so refreshing to see a director given the resources to really do whatever he wants and to fully execute his vision with no restraints. And that budget allows them to really bring this world to life. It allows the world to feel lived in through things like the incredible production design and the amazing costumes. On top of that, this is just a visually stunning movie from start to finish. I love how Martin Scorsese moves the camera and also the way he uses lighting to really enhance some of these scenes, especially some of the more emotionally driven scenes. At over 3 hours long, this movie moves at a brisk pace, thanks in part to the really effective editing. I was worried going in that there would be some moments that felt kind of dull because of that runtime, but I did not find that to be the case at all. I was constantly glued to the screen. Every scene moves the story forward. Every scene is intentional and purposeful and feels essential to the overall story. And like I said, some really cool editing choices in here that just allowed for enough unique distinctions between the scenes that kept it interesting. I also really like the score here. I'm definitely going to be listening to the score when it releases. There is a bass line that's kind of carried throughout the whole film, and the score just has like a nice momentum to it, a nice rhythm to it that kind of keeps the movie going, and it kind of gives it a sense of urgency simply through the music. Leonardo DiCaprio delivers maybe his best performance ever in this movie, and I know that's saying a lot, but I honestly believe that. He is phenomenal. He gives such a wide range of emotions in this movie, and he nails this character. He gets lost in this character, as you would expect, and it's one of those examples where I didn't see Leo, I saw Ernest. Especially as this movie goes along in the second half and in the third act of this movie, he has some incredible scenes and just some incredible showcases of him as an actor. I honestly think that he delivers the best performance of the year. I want him to win Best Actor. He is my pick for Best Actor as of right now. So yes, and then Robert De Niro is incredible in a very big role as well, big supporting role. He's incredible. He really makes you hate his character. Like, you really hate his character, and that's a testament to his performance. And then, of course, Lily Gladstone. A much more understated performance compared to those other two, but she nails it. She nails what her character is, what her character needs to do. She says a lot without saying a lot. Just through her face, just through her body language, She's able to communicate a lot. Another one of the best performances of the year. Now, as for complaints, it was definitely an intentional choice, but Scorsese really dives into every little part of this crime saga. You know, he tells you every single step of what happened, how different people were involved, how they went about, you know, doing these things. And I don't know if it was necessary to really dive into it with that much detail. I think the message still would have been communicated just as effectively. I think that you wouldn't really lose anything, but at the same time, I don't think those scenes really drag the movie down at all because it's so well done, because it's still very well paced. I also think that we could have gotten more of Molly's perspective, you know, really diving into how she's processing everything that's happening, her thoughts on all the events that are occurring, because she is the one who is most directly impacted by everything that's happened in so many ways. And we do get a little bit of that, but I don't think we got enough. We're really focused on Leonardo DiCaprio's character, which I think was the right move for this story. But I do wish we would have gotten just a little bit more of Molly and that her character was a bit more fleshed out. Overall, this is a phenomenal movie, one of the best of 2023. And as Martin Scorsese would say, this is cinema. These are the movies that we don't really see made much anymore. These are the movies that we should support in theaters if we want to see more of them made. So please go and see this movie in theaters. It's honestly a super entertaining movie, even at 3.5 hours long. So don't let that long runtime discourage you from going to see it. So let me know down in the comment section below what you thought of this movie once you've gotten a chance to see it. And while you're down there, comment what your favorite Martin Scorsese movie is. I want to know. Mine is maybe Goodfellas. I know that's a pretty basic answer. That or Wolf of Wall Street. So anyways, that is it for this review. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification icon. It really helps the channel out. And if you want to check out more of our reviews, you can click on either of the video icons right over there. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one. See ya.